Hello, today I'm here on the eMove 360 fair in Munich for Electromobility, and I'm here on the stand of Huber Automotive and StreetDrone, and I'll try my first interview in English. This is here a car looking like a Twizy, and this is Adrian Bedford from StreetDrone, and he will explain me what is the difference to this standard Twizy.
So we take the ordinary Twizy and we take off the bodywork. We put on a carbon fiber body. It gives us a bit more space in the back to put cameras on the side, a LiDAR on top if you want, and a big computer in the back.
What will you do with the cameras on this side,
for example, if you want to change them, we have these things which we call joggles, so you can have different forms, you can have different numbers of cameras. This setup has 8 cameras, some of our customers have 7 cameras.
Those cameras are for automotive drive?
They're automotive, they're Siconics cameras. These particular ones are Siconics cameras. You don't have to have those, you could have USB cameras if you want.
And here on the back side, there is the computer.
So this is an NVIDIA PX2, which has hardened car connectors, which are very important. If the car's bouncing about, moving about, then something might come loose. But these connectors are designed so that they won't come loose. So here you see we've got the 8 cameras connected. It's capable of actually taking 12 cameras on this particular.
Up to 12 cameras?
Up to 12 cameras, exactly.
And this computer, which power has it?
Well, it has 4 GPUs in it. So it's got 2 CPUs and 4 GPUs in total. So it's really quite powerful.
And what is, for example, possible with this car? So you developed delivered, I think, 10 cars already?
We have sold 10 cars. So in StreetDrone, we're based in Oxford. We're mostly Oxford grads. We have converted the Twizy into a development platform. The StreetDrone itself, it's capable of being an autonomous vehicle, but the purpose of it is to provide a platform for others to develop their autonomous and mobility solutions, try out experiments, exercise their data collection activities. So we have sold just to Huber. We're based in Oxford. One of our customers here in Germany is Huber Automotive, who are based near Stuttgart, and they have a particular niche market that they want to develop an autonomous vehicle for.
Adrian, you will show me that it is possible to make a drive with a control unit?
It is. I will get one of my colleagues in to show you and to give a demonstration of the driving. Okay, if you just want to bear with me for a moment. Our system has a safety critical ECU that listens on our CAN bus.
ECU, what's that?
An electronic control unit. We publish the DVC file for the CAN bus that allows people to control the car's actuators.
So it's all possible via CAN bus to control the car?
Absolutely. So this handset is an emulator and it emulates what the computer does in the back. We can't drive in here completely autonomously, but we can emulate what the computer would do with this controller. And this produces the right signals on the CAN bus to control the car.
So this controller has a CAN bus output?
Exactly.
And then you drive, you control the car here?
Yeah, that's it, exactly. Okay. So my colleague...
So you can change the wheels now?
That's right. We need to...
And now they will drive autonomously or with the CAN bus, and we will see it. Wow. CAN bus driven car here on the eMove 360. And I'm here on the fair booth of StreetDrone and Huber Automotives. And Adrian Bedford told me that this would be a nice adventure for this company. And you, what is your planning about the next years? You have sold 10 cars, and what do you think will go on?
So our next step is we are working with Azure. We are with Microsoft Azure. We're putting our data onto that, and we think that data will become incredibly important. Everybody here at eMove is talking about the electrical charging, and we think that there will be a lot of synergies between the charging units and data collection.
So it also be possible that it is an interface for smart grid concepts and so?
Absolutely. The other thing that people are working on is the infrastructure and being able to pass data through items within the infrastructure of cities. Mm. So working with the city councils within the UK to put communications infrastructure within their street lights or traffic lights.
Oh, yeah. Very interesting. Thanks, Adrian, for this very interesting story about your new car platform. And your platform will be hopefully success in the next years.